Hello everyone. Today in this video, we will be covering the concept called as Introduction to Business Economics. Under this concept, we will be covering topics like the meaning of business economics, characteristic features of business economics, the differences between economics and business economics, concepts like microeconomics and macroeconomics. Before we could understand the meaning of business economics, let's look into what does economics mean. Economics was derived from the Greek word oikonomia, which means household management or management of house affairs. To give an example, it deals with how a person allocates his salary. That is, we know that the limited resources are on the one end and there are unlimited ones on the other hand. So it basically implements or includes economic theory and principles in allocation of these resources in an effective manner. Therefore, to put it in a nutshell, economics is a study of how a society allocates its limited resources. Let's move on to understand the concept of business economics. The word itself says business economics, meaning integrating economic theory and principles into the business. But where does business utilize these economic theories in business? There are various areas where business has to take decisions, like production decisions, financial decisions, human resource decision, distributive decisions, etc. So for all of these areas, there is a constraint of limited resources. But whereas it uses these economic theories and principles, it integrates it and comes with the best utilization of these resources to maximize the profits. Therefore, business economics is nothing but integrating economic principles into the business. Let's move on to objectives of business economics. Objectives include effective allocation of resources, integrating economic theories and principles into the business, and the other objective is, of course, profit, sales or wealth maximization in the business by making effective decisions. The next concept is understanding the characteristic features of business economics. The first feature talks about applied economics. So when we say business economics, it is a branch of economics which uses economic theories and principles and applies into the business. Therefore, we can say it is an applied economics. The second feature says it is micro in nature. Basically, economics include micro and macroeconomics, where we will be understanding the meaning of these two in much detailed manner in the next part of the video. But micro in nature basically means it looks only into the firm's perspective, and therefore we call it as micro in nature. The next characteristic feature is it is normative in approach. Normative in approach basically means it gives certain standards, certain laws, etc. But businesses will use these standards as how it is relevant to their particular business, calling it as pragmatic in approach. To give an example, law of demand is same for every business. That is, where rise in price leads to fall in demand and fall in price leads to rise in demand. But using this law for different business will be in a different way, because each business deals with different kind of a product, different nature of the product, different target market, different consumer base, etc. Therefore, pragmatic approach basically means using what is right for your business. Next feature says macro analysis. Though it is micro in nature, it analyzes the external environment like political factors, economic factors, legal factors, social factors, ecological factors in order to take decisions for micro perspective, that is from business perspective. And of course, the next feature says it is a study of allocation of resources and it is a study of decision making in a business. Now moving on to the concepts like micro and macroeconomics. Micro and macroeconomics are the terms given by Ragnar Fish in the year 1933. So micro means individualistic, whereas macro means aggregate approach. So let's try and understand what is microeconomics. So when we say microeconomics, it is a branch of economics which deals with individual units. So individual units like producer, consumer, particular product, price of the product, etc. So business economics will use more of micro aspects like this, demand, supply, etc. It also helps in answering the economic problems like what to produce, how to produce, for whom to produce, etc. So when we say what to produce, what product to produce, for whom to produce is the consumer base or the target market, etc. So this is micro perspective or individualistic in nature. Moving on to macroeconomics. Macroeconomics is another branch of economics which deals the aggregates of these individual factors that we spoke about. That is aggregate demand, aggregate supply. It can be national income, GDP, and also it can be inflation, deflation, etc. So macroeconomics studies the economy as a whole. So to differentiate between microeconomics and macroeconomics, the first point of differentiation will be the meaning of these two concepts. So the meaning says microeconomics is much individualistic in nature, where it studies the individual units, whereas macroeconomics studies the aggregate of these individual units. Moving on to the scope of micro and macroeconomics. The scope of microeconomics would be studying of individual demand, supply, product, firm, family, etc. Whereas macroeconomics covers the entire economy as a whole, studying of the national income, the price level in the country, the GDP in the country, etc. Limitation to the concept of micro and macroeconomics. One of the limitations says, under microeconomics, it has an assumption of full employment, which is an unrealistic concept. Whereas the limitation for macroeconomics is that whatever is right for the aggregate may not be true for the individual. Say for example, if we look into the GDP rate of a country, if we say there is a rise in the GDP rate of the country, it doesn't mean all the sectors in the economy is contributing in the same manner. Each sector contribution might be different. So therefore, the picture of the aggregate may not be true for the particular individual sector as such. So these are the few points of differences for micro and macroeconomics. So the last concept is to understand in general what is the difference between economics and business economics. So when we say business economics, it is much limited in its scope, whereas economics has a much wider scope. Business economics integrates the economic theory, but whereas economics gives us that particular theory. So business economics is micro in nature, whereas economics is macro in nature. The last point of difference could be business economics deals with the theories like profits, but whereas economics deals with the theories like profit, wages, interest, etc. So that was the short introduction to the concept of business economics, microeconomics and macroeconomics. For further topics, please do subscribe for more videos.